Are you curious about hot flashes and how to reclaim your cool? Join me for a deep dive into this common menopausal symptom, how they typically play out, and the power-up tips you need to tame those fiery friends. Hi everyone, I'm Dr. Alba, EGP with a special interest in women health and menopause. Welcome to my channel. Today we'll be exploring hot flashes. Feel free to leave any questions in the comment below and don't forget to suggest ideas for future topics. Hit the subscribe button and smash that like. Get ready for awesome stuff on the way. Many women experience hot flashes, also known as hot flashes, as a common symptom during menopause. Don't let the name fool you. Hot flashes and hot flushes are just fancy dress names for the same fiery fiesta happen in the body during menopause. Whether you are in North America or sipping tea across the pond, this uncomfortable experience knows no borders. These sudden waves of intense heat, often associated by sweating, rapid heartbeat, and flushed skin, are caused by the hormonal change that occurs during this stage of life. Imagine you nailing this presentation, feeling confident and on top of your game. Then, boom, a tidal wave of heat engulfs you. Your face turns into a tomato on steroids. Your blouse feels like a dump dishcloth. And your colleagues think you accidentally sat on a heating pad. Welcome to the wonderful world of hot flashes. Or is it flush? As women approach the menopause, they over-decrease estrogen production, a key hormone involved in a variety of body functions, including temperature adjustments. This hormonal imbalance can send mixed signals to the hypothalamus, the brain's central hub for thermoregulation. This temperature control works similarly to a house heating system. Imagine the hypothalamus as a house thermostat that measures temperature. If the house gets cold, the thermostat it will tell the radiator to turn on and heat it up. Conversely, if the house is too hot, the radiator will be told to switch off. Serving as the body thermostat, the hypothalamus monitors blood temperature, ensuring the body ideal 37 degrees Celsius for peak metabolic function. For instance, when body temperature rises, the hypothalamus gives orders to the blood vessel to widen and increase sweat production to cool the body down. This process, known as vasodilation, causes a rush of warm blood to the skin, resulting in a flushed appearance typically associated with hot flashes. On the other hand, if the body temperature is low, the hypothalamus instructs blood vessels to narrow, keeping them away from the skin surface to preserve heat. Additionally, muscle may contract vigorously, causing shivering to generate heat. The estrogen decreasing during menopause can disrupt the hypothalamus. This can lead to misinterpretations of the body temperature, triggering the cooling mechanism even when there is no actually overheating, resulting in an uncomfortable experience of hot flashes. So hot flashes are basically the fire aftermath of a hormonal mosh pit, where the brain throws a wobbly on the thermostat settings, mistaking a mind breeze for a sauna. No wonder why I feel like a human furnace. Exactly right. And while hot flashes are the most noticeable symptoms, there is a whole lot more going on underneath the surface. This sudden vasodilation can cause heart palpitation, anxiety, sleep disturbance, and other uncomfortable experiences. Thanks for the info. Any idea how long I'm stuck on this brain part gone wrong? Studies suggest the average woman experiences hot flashes for around 7 years, with some experiencing them for up to 11 years or longer. The duration and frequency of individual hot flashes also vary greatly, lasting around 4 minutes for most women. They can occur just a few times per week or as often as once an hour. Enough of science. I'm feeling like toasty. What can I do to turn down this personal sauna situation? When tackling hot flash, consider exploring three key avenues: lifestyle adjustment, hormonal treatment tailored for your needs, and alternative therapies. Staying cool and reducing stress are the main lifestyle changes that can help manage hot flashes. Some women find relief by avoiding warm room, hot drinks, and wearing layers of light clothes. Cooling products like spray, gel, and portable fans can also be helpful. Certain factors such as spicy food, caffeine, alcohol, and smoking can trigger hot flashes. Avoiding these triggers may decrease the frequency of hot flashes. To reduce stress and promote better sleep, exercise regularly and practice stress management techniques like meditation and yoga. Additionally, maintaining healthy weight can minimize hot flashes, as women who are overweight tend to experience them more frequently. Hormone replacement therapy, HRT, replaces the estrogen hormone that the ovaries stop producing. In addition, it's essential to include a progestogen in the treatment for women who still have the womb. There are many different types of HRT, so it's important to discuss the options with your doctor. The benefits of taking HRT often outweigh the risk for many women. Cognitive behavioral therapy, CBT, is a type of talk therapy that helps people develop coping mechanisms and address negative thoughts related to menopause, improving self-esteem and mood. Hypnotherapy can help women address challenging menopause symptoms like hot flashes and sleep issues. This evidence-based approach uses mental images for coolness and control, showing significant reduction in hot flash frequency and intensity compared to control groups. For women who cannot or choose not to use hormonal replacement therapy, exploring alternative prescription medications with the doctor is a possibility. These medications include some antidepressant, blood pressure medication, and an anti-epilepsy medication, can potentially help with hot flashes, night sweats, mood issues, and anxiety. Individual suitability and potential side effects should be considered before using this medication. Additionally, it's important to remember that menopause treatments have a very strong placebo effect, meaning even inactive treatments can improve symptoms for some people. Seeking natural relief for menopause is understandable, but be cautious. Herbal remedies often lack robust regulation and consistent ingredients, raising concern about their safety. Natural doesn't guarantee safety, and their effectiveness is often debated, as they could have side effects and interact with other medication. Always consult your doctor before taking any herbal remedy and look for the THR certificate logo mark, if available, indicates some level of oversight. Most importantly, remember you are not alone. We are a band of menopausal Amazon. So reach out to your sisters, share your worst stories, and maybe even start a hot flash fun club. You'll be surprised by the companionship and wisdom that comes from knowing you are not the only one hosting a permanent inner sauna. Don't let the hot flash hold you back. Explore the options available and unlock the secrets to manage them effectively. Talk to your doctor and discover what works best for you. Take control of your menopause journey. Thanks for joining. Or should I say join us?
As sounds better.
Thank you for joining us. Until next time, stay empowered.